Recently, we adopted our 10-year budget. It's one of the most difficult we've ever had to deliver, and it's the recovery budget aimed to respond to the $750 million hole in council's income caused by COVID-19.
Instead of cutting services and infrastructure investment, we have worked hard to preserve what is most important to our communities while reducing non-essential spending.
Over the next decade, we will invest a record $31.8 billion in the critical infrastructure Auckland needs, which will stimulate economic recovery and create jobs.
This includes a $4 billion boost for water, wastewater and stormwater.
$600 million more towards Auckland's $31 billion transport package.
And a further $900 million for our parks and community facilities that make Tāmaki Makaurau a great place to live, work and play.
We remain focused on tackling climate change with $152 million of new spending to reduce emissions and adapt to global heating.
We will extend and increase the water quality targeted rate to fast track improvements across the region, especially from Parnell to Glendawe, the Tāmaki Estuary and the Monakau Harbour, adding to the important work we're already doing on the Waitemata Harbour.
The natural environment targeted rate will also be extended for another 3 years to make sure we maintain the strides we've already made to stop the spread of Kodu dieback disease and tackle the pests that are killing our native birds and trees.
And we have increased the asset renewals budget by 50%, so future generations of Aucklanders do not experience burst wastewater pipes and contaminated water like we've seen in some other places around New Zealand.
To help pay for this, we're becoming a far more efficient organisation, locking in yearly savings of $90 million.
And a one-off average general rate increase of 5% will be introduced next year before returning to a 3.5% in following years.
This compares to proposed double-digit increases in Wellington and Tauranga.
It hasn't been easy, but with your support, we've delivered a budget that will boost economic recovery and will continue to deliver the infrastructure and services Aucklanders need.